Dear international friends, actually we are running an online course in German language, and during this clinic we have every week one Facebook live event that the writers can ask questions. And there we had one very interesting question, and I will try now to translate it into English because I think it's maybe very interesting for you too. So the question was, what is forward? And especially for me is the difference between forward and fast, because forward does not mean riding fast. For example, if you have a racehorse, the racehorse can go on, I think, in 60 kilometers per hour, so very fast. And later, if you change the racehorse, if you school him to be a riding horse, you will discover if you want to go forward and you close your legs, maybe the horse will not react. Because in the past he was running fast, but he was not ridden forward. That does mean he does not understand the aids, especially your leg. So if you touch a very sensitive horse, like a thoroughbred, with your legs, normally they do everything, but they don't go forward or don't go on, because they start to move the skin, they start maybe swinging the tail, and they contract even, but they don't want to go on because they never learned what means the rider's leg. So, because normally we think, on a racehorse, if I close my legs, we go forward and fast. But no, it's the contrary normally. So we have to teach the horse the meaning of our leg, that the horse understands, yes, when the rider's leg will touch me here, I have to go on. So going forward is a result of education, of training, and of gymnastic, because the horse, even if he understands your aids, you have to put him physically in a position that he can follow your aids. For example, you want to do lateral movements. That's the topic of our online clinic. You want to do lateral movements, and you are riding in a very good rhythm and trot, and now you start the lateral movement and your horse doesn't go on in this rhythm. He doesn't continue like in the same way he was before. He starts to go more slow. Maybe he makes mistakes in the rhythm. So that does mean he's not forward, because he doesn't go on fluently as before. And if the horse knows the meaning of your leg, and even he wants to go on, if he's physically not in the situation, because he's maybe much too stiff to go by side, the horse cannot follow your leg when he's physically not in a good moment. And that is dressage. Is one part is education, and one part is gymnastic, that the horse is really able to follow our aids. And that means forward, means being on the aids of the rider. That means that I can, in every second, I have the horse under control, and I can go forward, by side, or even rein back can be forward too, and the horse answers immediately to my aids. That means forward. There's a very famous sentence of an old German master, of Steinbrecht. He said, ride your horse forward and straight, and put him straight. And it's so true, but very often it's misunderstood, because he wants to tell you, put your horse on your aids, that you really can control your horse, and put him straight. And if you want to put a horse straight, we have to use lateral movements. So this master, he did not mean go long and straight lines and ride fast. No, no. He wanted to explain, put your horse on the aids and try to balance the body of your horse, that at the end he has the same weight on each leg, that he's really straight, not on the shoulders and not in his length hanging on one side. That does mean put your horse forward and put him straight. Another example is, if I want to do a levade with my horse, you have the maximum of forward in this exercise, because your horse is first in Piaf, and then he really has the wish to go on, and you take him a little, and as the energy is there and wants to go on, wants to go out, so the horse cannot move forward, and you are there, so the energy goes up. So even there's a moment, the horse puts his weight on his hind legs and lifts the forehand, and that's the maximum of forward. So this horse is really on the eights. The contrary is when the horse is rearing, then he's also on two legs and he's up with the forehand. But that's really a big, big difference, because a horse rearing is completely behind the eights. He does not cooperate with the rider anymore, and you have no chance if you are on a horse like this. You are sitting on the horse and you just can wait until he goes down again, and you are completely helpless. So rearing is the maximum of being behind the aids, is not forward anymore the horse, and a levade is the maximum of forward. So you see, in dressage, the good and bad things very often are very close together, and we need many, many years of experience, and we have to learn a lot to make the difference what is good and what is bad. The Piaf is another thing that shows us if the horse is forward. When the horse is really ridden and reacts very well on our aids in each situation, and is trained very well, he can do Piaf, and this is also a maximum of forward, even it's on the same place. The horse does not move on, so Piaf is on the place, but it's an exercise maximum forward. But you have to see the rider sitting on the horse and being really one with the body of the horse. You just see one body at the end, and the rider should not give strong aids with the legs or spurs or whip. The rider should just be together with the body of the horse, and the horse should move brilliant and with lightness, and then the horse is forward. If you see riders moving the legs and pushing and even lift the hands and try to get the horse in Piaf with a red head and really a lot of muscle work, these riders, they don't have the horse forward, because in the important moment the horse starts to lose energy and is lazy. He does not react on the aids, so he's not forward. Even if the horse is ridden before half an hour in a very fast trot and canter, he was fast ridden half an hour before the Piaf, but not forward, because in the moment he should react, there's no reaction. And another horse maybe is trained like we do it in lateral movements, almost in slow motion, maybe in lateral movements by side, and you collect energy and you start to give the horse a good body feeling, and the horse will find his balance. And then if you have collected energy in a calm work, then you have the chance in every second to let the horse explode. So maybe the horse can go forward in canter, he can go in a Piaf, in passage, rein back and start very quick, whatever you want, because you have the horse under control and on your aids. But it has nothing to do with going fast as a preparation, it has to do with gymnastic. And so that's what I want to explain. Even the lateral movements, if you do them very slow, it does not mean that you have your horse not forward. It means that you put your horse on your aids, and that's the point. And if you have your horse under control, one day is coming a strange situation, your horse maybe is a little bit scared, you don't have a problem, because as you have the horse first on your aids, no problem. Second, the horse knows a lot of lateral movements, so you always can pass, for example, in a light shoulder in, you put the horse with the head to the other direction, you put your inside leg and you can pass. So the horse maybe is a little bit scared, but is under control. And that's very important for us as riders, that we really can trust our horse and the horse trusts us, because he knows our aids. Other horses, they are running in trot, 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 canter, boring work, always the same very fast circle, circle, straight, all around. So head down is very boring. And these horses, very often, they are just waiting for a moment to escape. So maybe there's something, the horse is looking a little, he starts to be a little bit spooky. And then suddenly you see these horses running away, bucking or doing funny things. And the rider has no control anymore because they are not on the aids. Even before this situation happened, the horses were running around in high speed. They are not forward. So that's the big difference between riding forward, having a horse on the aids, and riding fast. So don't mix it up. And if you do a good gymnastic and a good education to your horse, sure, you will have your horse on your aids and has nothing to do with speed. You will discover it. So thank you very much for your interest.